time and the world do not stand still. Change is the law of life. And those who look only to the past or the present are certain to miss the future. I said, are certain to miss the future.
I missed that. Prime Minister Castro, this missile crisis was the last straw. We almost blew ourselves up. Now we invite you here today.
Good faith.
In good faith.
Así entendemos los revolucionarios cubanos nuestro deber internacionalista. Así entiende nuestro pueblo sus deberes, porque entiende que el enemigo es uno, el mismo que nos ataca a nosotros en nuestras costas y en nuestras tierras, el mismo que ataca a los demás. Y por eso decimos y proclamamos que con combatientes cubanos podrá contar el movimiento revolucionario en cualquier rincón de la tierra.
Major Guevara, in your speech to the General Assembly day before yesterday, you accused the United States of helping Cuba's neighbors prepare new aggression against her. We, in turn, have often accused your government of abetting subversion in other Latin American countries. Do you see any way out of this situation, any way to improve relations?
I think with regards to solutions, there are solutions, and I think there is only one. We have said repeatedly to the government of the US that we do not want anything but to forget us, that they do not consider us even for good or evil.
Well, generals, as you know, these days our government and country is facing really, really difficult times with communism. And we have a big threat that's called Fidel Castro. We need to solve this problem. What are your ideas?
I think, Mr. President, that we should apply economic sanctions. We should go through the diplomatic pathway instead of a violent plan.
Actually, as long as I respect Gabriela's professional opinion, I still believe we should attack.
Mr. President, please consider that you have been only a year president. It's too soon for you to take such violent decisions.
Well, generals, both of your opinions are very valuable for me, but I must take the decision that is best for my country and my people. So we're gonna plan the assassination of Fidel Castro. We need to plan it right away.
Estar. Fidel não me lo mata, hijo de puta.
Still alive, man. Still got to go get him. Go get him, man.
Ah!
We're coming for you.
Puedes matarme a mí, pero nunca la revolución, hijo de puta.
Die, you crazy old man!
Son of a bitch. I think he's dead, man. Let's go.
Gracias, gracias. La concha de la lora, pero ¿qué es esto? Mataron a Fidel. ¡Mataron a Fidel! ¡A comecera! ¿Sí? ¡Sí! ¡Mataron a Fidel!
Yo no sé nada, papi.
Putos imperialistas, la concha. Van a pagar. ¡La concha vas a pagar, Kiri!
Texas. Una vez en Texas te mato, Kennedy. Te mato. Te mato.
There must be a way that is out of here. Send the Joker to the thief. There's far too much confusion, and I can't get no relief. Businessmen, they drink my wine, now I'm lifted by earth. And none of them along the line, no one, any of this is really worth.
Imperialistas, solo quieren el poder. Imperialistas, dejen Cuba. Igualdad, eso es lo que necesita Cuba. Kennedy, tú y tu capitalismo y tu imperialismo van a caer. ¡Por Cuba!
Puta, casi que no llego. La escala está mierda.
Kennedy, tú no, no quieres, quieres a Cuba, quieres a nadie de nosotros. Tu democracia es solo un interés. Fidel, Fidel, Fidel sí apoyaba al pueblo, Fidel apoyaba a la gente. Sus planes eran una verga, pero apoyaba a la gente. Siempre, siempre fue mi amigo. Siempre logramos todo lo que queríamos. Siempre quería que los pobres salieran adelante. Pero Kennedy, Kennedy siempre metido. Metido.
Más.
Por ti, Fidel.
Partido Comunista de Estados Unidos. Internacional. Partido Comunista Reunión.
Ahí tengo que ir. Ahí encontraré ayuda.
A cruzar el borde. Y en el borde a Texas.
Să adresez senin rugămintea de a lua cuvântul la această mare adunare populară a oamenilor muncii din capitală, a mult iubitului și stimatului conducător de partid și de țară, a eminentului revoluționar patriot, care de peste 6 decenii și-a dăruit întreaga activitate binelui, prosperității patriei, libertății, independenței depline a României socialiste, secretarul general al partidului, președintele Republicii, tovarășul Nicolae Ceaușescu.
So, why did you come to the United States?
Man, honestly, I'm gonna take Kennedy's life.
What? How do you plan to do that?
Well, Kennedy's gonna give his speech in Dallas. He's gonna be in a car and I'm planning to shoot him. What do you think about that?
That's insane. And how are you gonna do it? Like,
I don't have a gun. I don't have a place to plant all my stuff. I don't have anything to carry on this shit. But, Muslim man, what is your name? What is your name?
Lee Harvey.
Harvey. I was thinking about if you could help me to handle this.
You want me to help you kill the president of the United States?
Yes, in fact, but it's kind of an important revenge. They took away my leader. I'm gonna take away theirs.
Okay.
So, what do you think about? Man, I'm asking you seriously. Are you sure about this?
Yeah, let's do this.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Is communism in your veins?
I think it is. I can provide you with a gun. I'm a pretty tight shooter and we can do this.
Okay, man. I appreciate that. Let's do it.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Moment, and here comes the president now. In fact, he's not in his limousine. He's departed the limousine and he is walking. He is reaching across the fence, shaking hands with many of the people who have come here to see him. He is closely accompanied by Dallas police officers and, of course, the Secret Service. He is now shaking hands and they are walking along the line of the fence, shaking hands with some of the hundreds of people who have come here to view their arrival. And now the President and First Lady are retreating from the fence. They're heading now for the official limousine where Governor Connally stands waiting their arrival so that they can make their way downtown and out to the trade mart. But this was one of those impromptu moments.
I can do this.
Let me tell you something. Once he turns the corner, we're gonna shoot him in the head.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
As soon as I have a clear view, I'll shoot his brains out.
For which President Kennedy is so well known, so many times you have heard that the Secret Service men suddenly find themselves without the president, that suddenly he has left them and stepped into the crowd, the milling throng, and decided to shake hands and give his personal greetings. And this, once again, he did. There's the gunmetal gray limousine, blue and gray, pulling away now from the fenced area. The President and Mrs. Kennedy seated on the back seat. Governor and Mrs. Connolly on the second seats or jump seats. And then the official driver and Secret Service men are in the front seat. A flying wedge of some one dozen Dallas police motorcycles leading the way.
Fidel, siento que he cumplido la parte de mi deber que me ataba a la revolución cubana en su territorio y me despido de ti, de los compañeros, de tu pueblo, que es ya mío. En los nuevos campos de batalla llevaré la fe que me inculcaste, el espíritu revolucionario de mi pueblo, la sensación de cumplir con el más sagrado de los deberes, luchar contra el imperialismo donde quiera que esté, hasta la victoria siempre.
Mr. Khrushchev, great to see you too.
Thank you.
Well, tell me how everything done.
I'm so excited. We killed that mother.
Great, there's great news.
Yes, and with this, Cuba is free now. And the US is weak. And that's the key point. The US is weak.
It's been a great job. You've been really helpful for this cause.
Let's
celebrate.
Thank you, Mr. Khrushchev.
Here.